Hope you're fine. I am also in good condition. The formation of our teeth start in the uterus in the sixth week of uterine life, and the first tooth erupt in our mouth is the deciduous or milky tooth, lower central incisors, and they erupt at the age of 6 months. There are 20 teeth in the deciduous or milky dentition. After that, in the 6 year of age, permanent teeth begin to erupt in the mouth. 6 to 12 years is the time period of mixed dentition. Some teeth are deciduous and the others are permanent teeth. After 12 years, all milky or deciduous teeth exfoliated and the remaining teeth are permanent teeth. But due to any reason like tooth decay, gum disease, any trauma, we lose our precious tooth. Then what are the options we have to restore that space or replace that tooth? The common options are: number one, removable partial denture, a simple acrylic denture that can be removed by the patient or by the dentist. Second option is fixed teeth, fixed partial denture or bridge, in which there is involvement of adjacent sound teeth. We have to grind the adjacent sound teeth and put crown on them, and with their support we place an artificial teeth, so called bridging of the teeth. And a third option, which is very common nowadays, is dental implants. A single piece of titanium drilled into the jawbone, and then we place a simple ceramic crown on top of this implant. That is the latest option in this era, but these all are artificial options with their disadvantages and side effects. So what will be in the future? Stem cell technology. In our natural tooth structure, nature gives 5 spots of stem cells. Near the root portion, there is apical papilla stem cells. Within the pulp or core of the tooth, dental pulp stem cells. Around the tooth, dental follicle stem cells and periodontal ligament cells. And last are exfoliated deciduous teeth stem cells. During my specialization period, I personally myself did a lot of cases of pulp revascularization, formation of new pulp in the tooth, and that is very successful option for preservation of the teeth, to close the root portion of the tooth and to elongate the root portion of the tooth. We utilize the natural stem cells and make a pulp like tissue within the root portion. So this is possible since 2004. But the main thing which is still in research is formation of a biotooth or biological tooth replacement. This technology is still in process. Scientists are successful in making new teeth but unable to shape them accordingly. Like every teeth has its own shape. Front teeth are wider and straighter, and the side teeth are sharper, pointed, and molars are more flat. So these shapes of each tooth is very unique and artistic, a gift given to us by the nature. So we are researching on these things, and in my specialty of endodontics, we did a lot of cases of pulp revascularization, but not a case of new tooth formation or new tooth creation with the help of stem cells. But in the rest of the world, scientists are working on this, and maybe in the future they will succeed in making a new tooth, which is called a biotooth or biological tooth replacement. That will be a good option. These are just like a seed. We insert it into the jawbone, and with the passage of time, just like the natural tooth, it will erupt from the jawbone and make a proper shape in the oral cavity. So this is a very amazing and important innovation. Maybe in the future, hopefully, we are waiting for this, as artificial teeth are not that good as natural teeth. Nature gives an organized structure of teeth, which are very technically attached to the jawbone with the help of thick fibers that are periodontal ligament fibers and have some elasticity. Even our natural tooth move with heartbeat. With heartbeat, our tooth move in a fraction of seconds, while dental implant, which is an artificial one, is fixed with the jawbone without any resilience or elasticity. So there is a chance of implant fracture in the future or implant mobility. So we pray for the formation of biotooth in the future, which is basically a derivative of stem cells, which nature gives us in our body, or we can get it from the blood of the patient, which is called as platelet-rich plasma or platelet-rich fibrin. These are also used as a rich source of stem cell. Hopefully, this video will be informative to you. If any question related to stem cells and formation of a new tooth, you can ask in the comment box. Thank you.